Hello dear students, welcome back to Learn Physics. In last class we were discussing about the theory portion, and that is some of the theory portions, that is formulas we discussed about from the chapter current electricity. In today's video we are going to discuss some of the MCQs relating to the chapter 3, that is current electricity. In this first question is, current in a wire varies with time according to the position I equals 4, according to the equation I equals 4 plus 2t. I is in ampere, t is in second. The quantity of charge which passes through a cross section of the wire during the time t equals 2 seconds to t equals 6 seconds. So we need to find out the charge when t equals 2 seconds to 6 seconds. If current is given, how can we find out the charge? Relation between current and charges, I equals dq by dt. Therefore, dq equals I dt. So, to find out the total charge, we need to integrate dq from 2 to 6. Right? So, instead of dq, I can substitute it as I dt. What is I? 4 plus 2t dt. Integral 4 dt is 4t plus integral 2t, that is 2 into t square by 2, applying the limits 2 to 6. So if I am applying the upper limit, I will be getting it as 4 into 6 minus 2 plus, next is 2 by 2 is 2 by 2 is 1. 36 minus 2 square is 4, right? So here 6 minus 2 is 4, 16 plus 36 minus 4 is 32. So here we will be getting the answer as 48 coulomb. So the answer is 48 coulomb. Clear? Now moving to the second question. How many electrons pass through a lamp in 1 minute if the current is 300 milliampere, given the charge on an electron is 1.6 into 10 to the power minus 19 coulomb. So for that, what and all are given? This question, all of you got it right. So I can wrap it, I guess. So the details, I'll be writing it over here. See, we can find out the how many electrons are passing through a lamp in 1 minute. So number of electrons we need to find out. And in 1 minute, for that time is given as 1 minute, that is 60 seconds. Current is equal to 300 milliampere, 10 to the power minus 3 ampere. Charge of electron is given as 1.6 into 10 to the power minus 19 coulomb. We need to find out N. Anyway, while finding out N, first itself it will come to our mind about the quantization of charge. Q equals NE. For that, Q is given, E is there. How can we find out? But this much of amount of current is passing through the circuit, right? For this much of current, how much, what will be the total charge? That one we need to find out first. Charge of one electron is 1.6 into 10 to the power minus 19 coulomb. Then for total charge in the circuit, how can we find out the total charge? Total charge in the circuit will be Q equals I into T. Now N we can find out Q by E, that is Q by charge of the electron. Charge of the electron here itself I am writing it as E. Otherwise you will get confused with this Q and this Q. So Q by E, Q equals IT divided by E. I value 300 into 10 to the power minus 3 into t is 60 seconds divided by 1.6 into 10 to the power minus 19. Okay, while you are solving, you will be getting it as 1.125 into 10 to the power 20 coulomb. Okay, so this is the final answer. Clear, right? How to find out? So what and all datas are given, try to write down the datas, then you can easily find out the answer. Okay, so next one. Third question. The plot represents the flow of current through a wire of three different times. The ratio of charges flowing through the wire at different times is. We need to find out the ratio of charges passing through the wire at different time. So here the time interval is given like first one from 0 to 2. Then for the second one, the time interval is given as 2 to 3. Then 3 to 4. Ratio of charges which is passing through the wire at different time. So here I and T is given over here. Okay. Current, the flow of current through wire at different times. So here charge, current and all, what is the formula? Q equals IT. So first we can find out this rectangle. So the if it is given I and T graph, then charge will be equal to area under the IT graph. Under IT graph will give you this charge. So in from 0 to 2, what is the first charge in this area? Q1, this area Q2, this area Q3. So Q1 is 1 into 2, so it is 2. Q2 is equal to, what is that? 2 into 1. This rectangle we can consider 2 into 1. Then the third one, Q3. Q3 will be equal to half BH. Half into 2. 3 to 5 it is 2. Into height is again 2. So here we are getting 2. So all the values we got it as 2 only. Therefore it is 1 is to 1 is to 1. 2 is to 2 is to 2. We can write it as 1 is to 1 is to 1. Okay, clear? Then next one. The drift velocity varies with the intensity of electric current as per the relation. Drift velocity, how it is relating with the electric field only given. We know the equation for drift velocity as I is equal to NAVDE. This formula we know. But with the capital E, how can we find out? See, drift velocity, first equation which we learned is E by M into V by L into 2. This is what we learned for the drift velocity as first equation while we are deriving. Right? This is the relation connecting current and drift velocity. Vd equals E by M into V by L into tau is the relation which we got from the derivation. So here instead of V by L, instead of this V, we can substitute it as E. V equals E into L. E equals V by L. So for V, we can write it as E into L. So E by M into E into L divided by L into 2. So how Vd is relating to E? Vd is directly proportional to E. Okay, so the answer is Vd is proportional to E. Now, next one. A metal wire is subjected to a constant potential difference. When the temperature of the metal wire increases, then the drift velocity of electrons in it is. What will happen to the drift velocity when the temperature of the metal wire increases? When the temperature increases, what will happen? The thermal velocity of the electrode, while we are increasing the temperature, if the temperature is increasing, what will happen? Velocity of the electrons will be increasing. Because of that, when velocity increases, what will happen? Collision will be increasing. If collision increases, what will happen to the relaxation time? The time required for, minimum time required for two successive collision, that will be decreasing. Okay, and relaxation times decreases. So what will happen to the drift velocity? Drift velocity also will be decreasing. Right? So drift velocity is directly proportional to the relaxation time. So here we can see the equation. I already told you the drift velocity Vd equals E by M into V by L into 2. Vd is directly proportional to 2. So as temperature increases, what will happen to the velocity? Velocity of the electrons will be increasing. And the drift velocity will be decreasing. Okay, so here in the question, when the temperature of the metal wire increases, drift velocity, what is happening to the drift velocity? Drift velocity is decreasing. So decreases the thermal velocity of the electron. Its thermal velocity of the electron decreases. This is wrong. Decreases, drift velocity decreases when the thermal velocity of the electron increases. Thermal velocity of the electron is increasing, drift velocity is decreasing. So these two terms comes together. So that is option D. So when we are increasing the temperature, the thermal velocity is increasing, therefore drift velocity decreases. Clear? So next question is, the drift velocity of the electrons in a copper wire of length 2 meter under the application of a potential difference of 220 volt 0.5 meter per second, their mobility. We need to find out the mobility. So for that, drift velocity is given as 0.5 meter per second, right? So drift velocity of the electron is 0.5 meter per second. Potential difference is given as 220 volt and length is given as length equals 2 meter. We need to find out the mobility. Mobility, how we can find out? What is the formula for finding out the mobility? Mobility and drift velocity is drift velocity divided by intensity of electric field. E, how we can find out? E equals V by L. Therefore, mobility mu equals Vd into L divided by capital V, right? Drift velocity is 0.5, L is 2 divided by capital V is 220. So here it is 110 divided by 0.5, right? So when you are solving this one, you will be getting the final answer as 4.5 into 10 to the power minus 3. So here it is. Nearly equal to 5 into 10 to the power minus 3. This is the correct answer. Okay. Next is, which of the following characteristics of electrons determine the current in a conductor? The drift velocity alone, a thermal velocity alone, then both drift velocity and thermal velocity, then neither drift nor thermal velocity. Which of the following electrons determine the current in a circuit, in a conductor? Current in a conductor is depending on the drift velocity, right? I is equal to NaVde. So it is depending on, current is depending on drift velocity. So the answer is drift velocity alone. Okay, clear children? So the rest of the topics we will be discussing in the next session. So I hope today's video is useful for you. And if you like the channel, please don't forget to subscribe, like and share. Thank you for watching. Bye.